Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to finalists of the 2017 International MEDIS Awards for Medical Research, accompanied by Mr. Tone Strnad, General Manager of MEDIS, the main sponsor of the event, and Professor Matija Tomšić, President of the 2017 MEDIS Award International Panel. Una Saga Serbika. Dobro večer.
Dobro večer.
Dear guests, welcome to Belgrade. Dear ladies and gentlemen, distinguished guests, Professor Dr. Vladimir Kostić, President of the Serbian Academy of Science. Welcome to the 2017 International MEDIS Awards for Medical Research Ceremony in Belgrade.
Dobro večer još jednom i dobrodošli. With this annual contest for the International MEDIS Award for Medical Research, MEDIS seeks and rewards the best applied research achievements in selected areas of medicine, chosen by an independent panel of scientists, and thus increases the distinguishability of the winners and their achievements in the profession and in general public. With these examples, MEDIS enhances awareness and promotes the importance of research for the development of medical science in the region and contributes to the diagnosis and treatment of diseases.
We are here tonight to honor the finalists and the winners and their contribution to medical science for the sake of a better future of the human life. The host of tonight's event is Mr. Tone Strnad, General Manager of Medis, the sponsor of the event. Please, Mr. Strnad, welcome. Dobrodošli.
Dobro večer. Nadam se da mi nećete zamjeriti ako pokušam govoriti srpski. Dobro večer svima. Drago mi je da smo večera zajedno. Dozvolite mi da se zahvalim baš svima koji ste večeras došli, a naročito onima koji ste doputovali iz drugih država i iz drugih gradova. Posebno pozdravljam našeg dragog gosta, predsjednika Srpske akademije nauka, akademika profesora doktora Vladimira Kostića. Također pozdravljam predstavnika proizvođača koje zastupamo na ovoj teritoriju, a koji su večeras sa nama. Pozdravljam učesnike našeg konkursa i komisiju i na kraju, a najvažnije, dozvolite mi da posebno pozdravim naše finaliste. Od osnivanja Medisa prije 30 godina željeli smo i vredno radili na tome da našoj teritoriji Balkana i uopšte ovog dela Srednje Europe obezbedimo nove i napredne terapije za naše pacijente. Shvatili smo da dosta proizvođača lekova ili medicinskih proizvoda, bili da su mali ili veliki, u stvari nema nikakvu nameru da se bavi našim malim ili rizičnim zemljama kao nas često vide. A onda, kada bi ih ubedili u to da su nam dali svoje proizvode za to tržište i kada nam se čini da smo imali potrebu pacijenata za lekom, da smo imali odličan lek, dobru podršku struke, i tada nije kraj. Borba kao da tek počinje, i to za financiranje, za liste, za priznavanje leka i potreba pacijenata. Kao što znate, odluku često određuje realnost koja se ogleda u budžetskim mogućnostima svake zemlje pojedinačno. Na svom razvojnom putu najčešće smo imali odličnu podršku vas, doktora i farmaceuta, i drugih medicinskih radnika. Na putu sa vama upoznali smo mnoge odlične, pametne i vredne ljude, one koji brinu za pacijente i za razvoj struke, bez obzira na veličinu zemlje, financijske mogućnosti, budžetske razlike, logičke prepreke itd. To je za poštovanje, to je za nagradu i ne za stalnu kritiku koju možemo čuti preko medija. I zato u trenutku kada smo slavili 25. godinu Medisa odlučili smo da učestvujemo u toj priči tako što i mi prepoznamo i nagradimo neke odlične naučne priče. Odlučili smo da nađemo najbolje objavljene kliničke i farmaceutske radove iz regije koja se rasteže od Austrije do Makedonije, da nagradimo autore skulpturom simboličkim imenom Budućnost i manjim finansijskim iznosom, da budemo sponsor tih nagrada, da informišemo o postojanju tih odličnih radova i druge naučnike i pre svega opšću javnost o tome da postoje lekari, farmaceuti koji u svoj svakodnevni rad sa pacijentima istražuju i brinu o tome kako i na koji način da produže i učine naš život boljim, zdravijim. I još nešto, a vrlo značajno, da odlučivanje o tome ko će dobiti nagradu prepustimo stručnjacima iz datih oblasti, i to nezavisnoj i međunarodnoj grupi tih stručnjaka, specijalista i kliničara. I ove godine imenovali smo nezavisnu stručnu komisiju sastavljenu iz poštovanih stručnjaka, profesora medicinskih i farmaceutskih fakulteta iz 7 država. Predsjednik stručne komisije je već drugu godinu za redom profesor dr. Matija Tomšić iz Slovenije. Zadatak komisije je bio da pregleda sve radove, a ove godine ih je bilo čak 166. Svih objavljenih u najboljim svetskim naučnim revijama, odličnih radova, onih koji pokazuju da naši doktori i farmaceuti imaju snagu i znanje da konkurišu u svetskoj nauci. Ja se ovim prilikom zahvaljujem komisiji za ogroman uloženi trud. Hvala. I kao što sam napomenuo, komisija je vredno radila, znaju se pobednici naše nagrade International Medical Awards for Medical Research, pa i mene zanima da čujem ko su dobitnici nagrada.
Hvala najljepše, odličan srpski.
Pa.
Thank you, Mr. Strnad, once again. Tonight we are very honored by the presence of the President of Serbian Academy of Science, who will address you as tonight's speaker of honor. Gospodine profesoru, doktore Vladimiru Kostiću, dobro večer, izvolite.
Dear awardees and finalists, dear medical staff, dear colleagues, people, particularly those of my age, are prone to hypocrisy and simple small lies like awards do not mean nothing to me. I don't want any type of recognition. It's not true. Simple human soul wants to be recognized, wants to be noticed, want to be realized in their efforts, either by community, people around her, to be noticed in everyday effort, in some small achievements which are making our everyday life. And this is actually something that I have in mind when I want to praise today the effort of MEDIS in the national world, to recognize some people and tell them, as I can see, even these small sculptures are not just a simple guest. I think much more than that, it's a simple thank you for what you are doing. On the other side, we all know that, and this is a old Serbian saying, that nobody or you cannot be a prophet in your village, let's say something like this. And today's awardees will be the prophets in their own village, because those from the independent expert panelist groups are actually from their village. They are able to recognize what they are doing and what is their advantages actually in the whole field. So today, when we are facing this fourth MEDIS award, with about, as I understood, 166 participants from 7 countries, from the fields of rheumatology, anesthesiology, gastroenterology, gynecology, neurology, that I didn't put neurology in the first place is a gesture of modesty of all neurologists, ophthalmology, pediatrics, pharmacy, and pulmonology. Finally, if we want to, besides the thanks to the MEDIS group, I want to say something to those who are younger among us, because they are particularly vulnerable. They are prone to these things on the sinusoidal behavior, from omnipotency to depression, that they cannot do nothing, that they are not worth of all these efforts, people around them, hopes that they have sometimes in their lives as students or as a young researchers have risen among their collaborators, etc., etc. I want to tell that we older are teaching them that the science and research is a torture, it's a hard work with a lot of sweating. As Churchill said, it's sweat, tears, and all these bad things. But I will say no, science and research is a game. There is a lot of fun. Try to play with your everyday life, with your everyday problems, with your everyday routines. Otherwise, the game is lost. Once again, try to play with your routines. Thank you very much.
Zahvaljujemo profesoru doktoru Vladimiru Kostiću, predsjedniku Srpske akademije nauka. Thank you, profesor doktor Kostić. Before we start with the presentation of our awards, we'll be joined with one famous singer from Serbia. You know all, who is he? Dame i gospodo, čast i zadovoljstvo mi je da vam predstavim Željka Joksimovića.
Ja znam da pevam i da snevam, jer ti i ja dva smo sveta različita, jer ti i ja, ko to zna, ko to zna, jer ti sveta različita, jer ti i ja, ko to zna, ko to zna. Kiša je padala, a ja sam plakao za njom. Ulica duga, ko moja tuga, ostaći u gradu to. Kiša je padala, a ja sam plakao za njom. Ulica duga, ko moja tuga, ostaći u gradu to. Znam da sve što brzo dođe, ja znam da mora i da prođe, jer ti i ja, dva smo sveta različita, jer ti i ja, ko to zna, ko to zna. Sam plakao za njom. Ulica duga, ko moja tuga, ostaći u gradu tom. Kiša je padala, a ja sam plakao za njom. Ulica duga, ko moja tuga, ostaći u gradu tom. Thank you.
od srca Željku Joksimoviću. I došao je trenutak koji nas je večeras sve ovde i okupio. So far the awards event have been placed twice in Ljubljana, once in Zagreb and this time in Belgrade. Until now, we received 560 applications. In this 4 year of Medis Awards, the organizer received a record number of 166 applications from medical doctors and pharmacists from 7 countries.
Here are the independent members of the international panel of distinguished and recognized specialists, which independently reviewed and assessed all the research works and chose finalists covering 9 therapeutic areas. You can see the members of the international panel on the screen.
The panel was chaired by the president, Professor Matija Tomšić, MD, PhD, specialist in rheumatology, who will be our next speaker tonight. Please, Mr. Tomšić, come on the stage and you can give me an applause. Thank you.
Dear ladies and gentlemen, I would like to begin by warmly welcome you all to Belgrade. I firmly believe that it is an excellent idea to award medical doctors and pharmacists who, in addition to being very busy performing their daily clinical duties, still find the time, energy, and willpower to carry out research work mainly during their weekends and nights. As a well-renowned Slovenian translator and writer recently said, an award really touches you and your heart. And there are many such awards for culture and journalism, for example, but in Slovenia there are practically none for medicine. Unfortunately, in Slovenia people only hear about doctors if something goes wrong. I was very honored when Medis invited me to be president of the international panel for 2017 Medis Award. We predefined the criteria of how the applications would be evaluated. These criteria were clinical research, impact factor of medical journal, if an applicant was first or leading author, and the number of authors. Furthermore, we agreed that pharmacists can only candidate in the field of pharmacy, and the neurologist only in the field of neurology. Our most important goal has been to be completely transparent and to reward the very best of the best. I believe that every member of the international panel who reviewed the applications in their category, as well as myself, accomplished our goal. From the 166 applicants from 7 countries that were nominated, we arrived at 19 finalists, and from this group choose 9 winners. I sincerely hope that this award will become the Oscar of the clinical research world in this region, so it will serve to encourage more and more medical doctors and pharmacists to get involved in the field of research. Thank you. Puno hvala na pažnji.
Thank you, Mr. Tomšić.
Okay, and molit ćemo sada gospodina Tone Strnada da nam se pridruži ovde, General Manager of Medicine, Martina Perharić, Managing Director of Pharma Division.
The 2017 Medis Awards contest was open to specialists from all of the 8 countries where Medis operates and covering a total of 9 specific research fields.
The work that was eligible was the clinical research work presented or published between September 1st, 2016 and August 31st, 2017 from doctors and pharmacists who presented their research work at European or world congresses or published their works in professional journals with a high impact factor.
The finalists and the winners were evaluated by the independent international jury from the viewpoint of the professional criteria. They chose the best among the applied research works.
As we already mentioned, a total of record 166 applications from 7 countries, and all 9 research fields were received and proceed. The international panel shortlists a total of 19 finalists, 2 in each category, with the exception of gynecology, where we have 3 finalists.
We have 6 finalists from Croatia, 4 from Slovenia, 3 from Serbia, 2 from Hungary and Austria, and 1 from Bosnia and Herzegovina. Before we start with the first award-winning ceremony, I would like to have just one more word about the prize. Each winner will be awarded a very special Medis Award sculpture named Budućnost, Future, made of bronze by the famous Slovenian sculptor of Bosnian-Croatian origin, Mr. Jakov Brdar, the author of many public statues and sculptures in the region. Mr. Brdar himself is the winner of one prestigious Slovenian Prešern Fund Award for the sculpture group Sermon to the Birds. Throughout his career, he also worked in Paris and Berlin. The sculpture is unique and therefore priceless. Each winner will be additionally awarded a financial stimulus for further research work in the gross amount of 2,500 euros. The shortlisted finalists will be awarded a special diploma.
And now I have the honor to once again greet Mr. Ton Strnad and Ms. Martina Perharić to be with us tonight. Dobro večer još jednom. And we are happy to announce the first award-winning ceremony according to the alphabet order of therapeutic areas. All the finalists are accompanied by a short video. Ja vas molim za još jedan veliki aplauz za sve finaliste, za najbolje u svom domenu. Hvala u njihovo ime. So we start with anesthesiology, and the finalists are Mr. Tihomir Molnar from Hungary.
Az utóbbi időben egy olyan kutatást kezdtünk, amely alapvetően vaszkuláris betegekkel, azaz érbetegekkel foglalkozik. Mi azt a technikát használjuk, hogy nem altatjuk el a betegeket, hanem úgynevezett regionál anesztéziában történik a műtét. Ez lehetővé teszi mind az érsebész, mind az anesteziológus számára, hogy a beteggel folyamatosan kommunikáljon. A mi kutatásunk az tulajdonképpen szintén a beteg biztonság javítását célozza. Ennek során biomarkereket, azaz molekulákat mértünk a betegeknek a keringésében, egyrészt a műtét előtt, másrészt a műtét alatt folyamatosan. Találtunk olyan markereket már a műtét előtti periódusban, amelyek előre jelezték, hogyha a betegnek a műtét alatt az agyi keringése romlik. A MEDIS által nyújtott támogatást vissza tudjuk forgatni ebbe a projektbe, és folytatni tudjuk ezt az úttörő munkát, egyrészt nagyobb betegszámon, esetleg más kórházak kollaborációjával együtt. Gondolok itt a határon túli környező országok orvosegyetemeivel is mi készek vagyunk felvenni a további kutatásokhoz a kapcsolatot.
Gospodin Molnar, naš prvi finalista. A druga finalistkinja je Miss Marija Stević from Serbia.
Znači, namera našeg naučno-istraživačkog rada, koji se ove godine našao u finalu, bavi se komparacijom dve vrste anestetika, ketofola i ketamina, znači kod dece uzrasta do 18 godina za laserske procedure, znači to je vrsta analgosedacije. Naša namera istraživanja bila je da prikažemo efikasnost i bezbednost anestetika kao i njihovo dejstvo na kardiovaskularnu i respiratornu funkciju. Dobijanje MEDIS nagrade za nas bi mnogo značilo, veliki doprinos našem teškom radu koji smo uložili da bi publikovali uopšte ovako jednu veliku studiju.
And the winner is
Mr. Tihamer Molnar from Hungary.
Congratulations, Mr. Molnar. And I will kindly please Mr. Molnar, after the photo shooting, to say something. And congratulations once again.
Ladies and gentlemen, dear colleagues, first I would like to congratulate both the organizers and the MADIS group for this excellent event. And the second, on behalf of my research team, I'm very grateful for MADIS award, and I can say you that definitely it is stimulate us doing research in the future and to serve our patients and to improve a better patient outcome. And third, I would like to congratulate to all of my colleagues who submitted their application, because I know how much effort is doing high quality research beside routine clinical practice. And finally, I would like to thank the support, my wife Susanna and my family. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Molnar. Congratulations once again. Thank you very much. Now we proceed with the next therapeutic area of gastroenterology. The finalists are Mr. Goran Hauser from Croatia.
U našem smo radu ispitivali mogućnosti prevencije post-RCP pankreatitisa. Post-RCP pankreatitis je najvažnija komplikacija RCP-a. U svakodnevnom kliničkom radu je od presudnog značenja pronaći adekvatan način prevencije. Davanje ceftazidima dokazali smo da je moguće prevenirati tu neželjenu komplikaciju post-RCP pankreatitisa kod pacijenata koji su dobivali taj antibiotik. Nominacija za ovu nagradu presudna mi je važnosti jer će to povećati međunarodnu vidljivost naših rezultata.
And the other finalist is Matthias Mandorfer from Austria.
The work under consideration has been presented at EASL ILC in 2016 and consecutively been published in the Journal of Hepatology, which is one of the leading publications in our field. This was the first study to investigate novel interferon-free regimens and their impact in patients who have already developed portal hypertension. Although the majority of HCV patients showed a decrease in portal pressure, some patients had progressive liver disease despite achieving a rheologic response. Using transient elastography, we were able to define liver stiffness cutoffs for the non-invasive identification of patients who have persistent, clinically significant portal hypertension after HCV eradication. This might facilitate post-treatment surveillance in these patients. I would like to thank my colleagues, as well as the patients and their families, and lastly, the jury for their consideration.
Congratulations from all. Now, Ms. Martina Perkerić will be announced who is the winner.
And the winner is Mr. Matthias Mandorfer from Austria.
Congratulations. Congratulations. And the winner's speech.
I won't leave this out of my hand. So,
Thank you very much. I would like to thank Karin Kotzbial, who is the shared first author of this publication, as well as Markus Pekradosevic, who is my mentor and very well known in this region. And lastly, I would like to thank the patients and the families.
Thank you once again, and congratulations.
Surprise.
Nije nego tremalo je pomalo da. Now we proceed with the third research field of gynecology. The finalists are three. For start, Mr. Andraž Dovnik from Slovenia.
We conducted a study about 2 years ago on the various prognostic factors which affect the survival of endometrial cancer patients. We found out that the hysteroscopy, which is the endoscopic method very widely used for diagnosing endometrial cancer, is associated with a higher rate of positive peritoneal cytology present endometrial cells in the peritoneal cavity. I would like to thank the scientific committee of Medis Awards. It's a great honor and also a great encouragement for the future. Thank you.
Gospodin Dovnik, prvi finalista. And the second finalist is Marina Ivanišević from Croatia.
Our work, which is nominated for the Medis Award, was connected with C-peptide values in type 1 diabetic pregnancies, for which we have concluded that the recuperation of pancreatic beta cells in type 1 diabetic pregnancies are induced more not only with the pregnancy but with additional nutrition such as vitamins and omega-3 fatty acids. We are very happy to be nominated for this work and research and would be very grateful if you would appreciate it too.
And the third finalist is Mr. Vedran Kardum from Croatia as well.
The aim of this study that was conducted by our Center of Excellence was to investigate one part of VNT signaling pathway in ovarian serous carcinoma. VNT signaling pathway is important in cellular stamina and cell transformation, and it's also indirectly included in the regulation of epithelial mesenchymal transition. The genetic controls and biochemical mechanisms underlying the acquisition of the invasive phenotype have been the areas of intensive research. I'm very happy and honored to be nominated for the International Medis Award for my research work. This nomination at the beginning of my research work is a great encouragement and inspiration for continuing towards a greater scientific achievements. Thank you, Medis.
And now,
Ms. Perharic will announce the winner of this category.
And the winner is Andraž Dovnik from Slovenia.
Mr. Dovnik is not here, but replaced with Professor Tomšić, replies him.
But you'll be on the photo, you know? Thank you once again, and congratulations to all the finalists. We still have six more awards to present, but let's ease the tension with another artistic break. So, thank you for the time being here, Mr. Strnad and Ms. Martina Perharic. Now we're happy to announce a very popular group, and you will enjoy a music block with group Cegi.
Cegi, on the stage. Thank you.
pitam se kad je sretnog Mila u ulici Kneza Mihajla, da li si žena od ovoga sveta ili se vila kroz Boga čela, da li si žena od ovoga sveta ili se vila kroz Beograd šeta. Jedna noć je samo bila naša, puna vina i slomljeni čaša. Jedna noć je provedena ludo i u duši napravila čudo. Jedna noć je samo bila naša, puna vina i slomljeni čaša. Jedna noć je provedena ludo i u duši napravila čudo.
Classical accordion.
Ha, svaka čast, svjetski šampion. Nije mala stvar, jel' tako? World champion. Okay, we shall continue. I invite Mr. Tone Strnad, general manager of Medis, and Ms. Albina Pečarić, hospital care director, to join us on stage to hand out the awards for the next three categories. Now, we continue with the fourth therapeutic area of neurology. The finalists are Mr. Zoran Vukojević from Bosnia and Herzegovina.
I have been working as a specialist neurologist in University Clinical Center in Banja Luka for 17 years. I have published a paper in the official journal of World Federation of Neurology. It was about a patient with neurosarcoidosis and intracerebral bleeding. When I saw MRI images of the brain, I was very surprised because of five separate intracerebral hematomas. I was surfing the internet and found only 20 patients with neurosarcoidosis with intracerebral hematoma, but none of them had multiple hematomas. I decided to study all of the previous published cases and wrote a paper about our patient. If I win Medis Award, that will be a big encouragement for my scientific research in the future. Moreover, with the help of this award, I would attend the Congress in field of neuropathic pain that will take place in Dublin next year.
And Ms. Veronika Rutar-Gorišek from Slovenia.
In my research, I was also interested in how the patients with a stroke in speech area also have other deficits that are related to dysfunction in functional networks responsible for other cognitive tasks. I am very happy to be nominated for this Medis Award because all of us who do research, we know that science is not dull, it's not boring, science is exciting and attractive, but with this event, we also know that science can be glamorous. I'm particularly excited to meet other researchers from this area with whom we are not close only geographically, but also historically.
And now, Ms. Albina Pečarić will be open the envelope.
And the winner is Veronika Rutar-Gorišek.
Congratulations, čestitamo.
Thank you very much. As you can see from the video, my research is really exciting, but actually most of the time it really is. But as it was said previously this evening, well, research can be exhausting. It can be all blood, sweat, and tears. And there are times when you don't really see the light at the end of the tunnel, and let alone the silver lining of it. And at those times, it is good to know that there is a reward, there is a celebration cake, and perhaps there is also a cherry on the top of the cake. So thank you for this reward, and I would especially like to thank my colleagues, my co-authors, and of course my husband, who's here and who is really been very supportive and very patient and really interested in what I do. And also another man who is attending this event, Professor Pirtošek, who is a huge inspiration for all of us neurologists of all generations. So thank you, and congratulations to all of the finalists.
Thank you once again. Our next research field is ophthalmology, and the finalists are Mr. Alexei Medic from Croatia.
Uvidom u dostupnu literaturu i iz vlastitog kliničkog iskustva, moj tim i ja smo primijetili da određeni broj pacijenata sa dijabetičnom retinopatijom ne postiže zadovoljavajuću vidnu oštrinu nakon operacije mrene. Razlog tomu bio je učestalija pojava edema tkiva u makularnom području nakon operacije. Ovim istraživanjem dokazali smo da preoperativna profilaktička primjena nesteroidnih antireumatika značajno smanjuje pojavu tog edema i poboljšava vidni ishod kod tih pacijenata. Izbor ovog rada od strane Medisovog međunarodnog stručnog odbora bila bi velika čast i priznanje i velika motivacija za dalji nastavak istraživanja iz ovog područja.
Prvi finalista, gospodin Medic, ovdje sa nama, and the second finalist is Miss Maja Živković from Serbia.
LASIK metoda predstavlja danas jednu od najčešće korišćenih metoda u refraktivnoj hirurgiji. Međutim, i dalje velika je dilema oftalmologa i kontroverzni su stavovi kada je u pitanju primjena ove metode kod pacijenata sa glaukomom. Rezultati našeg rada, odnosno naše studije, bili su da je LASIK bezbedna procedura i da ne dovodi do istanjenja sloja retinalnih nervnih vlakana, kao ni do istanjenja ganglijskog kompleksa retine. Ovo je izuzetna čast za ceo moj tim, jer ovo je jedini način da se ljudi motivišu, da vidimo da sve neprospavane noći, sav trud koji smo uložili nije uzaludan. Stvarno, izuzetna nam je čast i privilegija što smo nominovani kao finalisti za nagradu.
And the winner is...
Congratulations, čestitamo.
Congratulations once again.
So, ladies and gentlemen, dear colleagues, I am very grateful to be here tonight. It's a great honor to receive this beautiful award. I would like to thank people from Medis for organizing such a beautiful event. I would like also to thank the scientific committee for choosing my paper between lots of others, excellent papers from my colleagues, and also I would like to thanks my co-workers on this paper, especially Professor Jukic, head of our Croatian Ophthalmology Society. And last but not the least, I would like to thank my family for support and love. Thank you.
Thank you and congratulations.
Thank you very much. The next 2017 Medis Award will be awarded in the area of pediatrics. The finalists are Mr. Klemen Dovč from Slovenia.
I'm honored that our work was accepted for this final ceremony of Medis Awards for this year. At this point, I would like to acknowledge all the other members of our research team that contributed greatly for this achievement. At the first point, especially Professor Tadej Batelino and Professor Natasha Bratina, who were my mentors on this project. We believe that this acceptance for the final ceremony is a great marker of us heading the right way. We are focusing on the technological improvements, mostly on the artificial pancreas, which is automated insulin delivery based on glucose sensor data. So we can see with that their metabolic control improves greatly. And this is, of course, of great benefit for their future because it will reduce the burden and improve the quality of life.
And the second finalist is Judith Pichler from Austria.
My research theme is about children with intestinal failure on parenteral nutrition, and together with the team of Great Ormond Street Hospital, we have looked for various complications in these children. This award, the MEDIS International Award, I'm really proud to be announced as a finalist, and because this prize has a high reputation in the medical field.
Unfortunately, Mr. Deutsch and Ms. Pichler is not here tonight, but we must hear who is the winner of this contest in final for pediatrics.
Okay. And the winner is Clement Deutsch.
Mr. Clement Deutsch, replacing Mr. Professor Tomšić, will take award for him.
Yeah, we can go without the speech. Thank you so much and congratulations. Thank you, Ms. Pečarić and Mr. Strnad. And Mr. Strnad, this is a good exercise for you tonight, huh? Up, down, yeah, okay. We still have three more awards to go. In next few minutes, we'll listen again to one of the biggest stars in the region. Please welcome once again, Željko Joksimović.
Željko with you again, ladies and gentlemen.
Ostavljaš mi vremena za druge. Gledam kako veselo se krećeš, kao leptir oko moje tuge. Ima nešto u tom što me nećeš, nešto čemu sama ne znaš ime. Ima nešto u tom što me nećeš, a sve znači ne zaboravi me. Ima nešto u tom što me nećeš, o te laži, na čisto umreću. Ima nešto u tom što me nećeš i u tome što ja tebe neću. Ima nešto u tom što me nećeš. tebe neću. Čast mi je bila večeras s vama.
Idemo dalje. Ponovo, posle nekoliko puta da ponovim još jedan put. I invite Mr. Tone Strnad, General Manager of Medis, and Miss Elina Marta Čmarković, Managing Director of Serbia, to join us on stage to hand out the awards of the last three categories. Posljednje tri kategorije. Evo, polučimo se Marija i ja na naše pozicije. Our next award will be presented in the therapeutic area of pharmacy. The finalists are Miss Mladena Lalić Popović from Serbia.
Ovo istraživanje se bavilo konkretno prolaskom ranitidina kroz placentalnu barijeru kod žena koje imaju normalnu trudnoću i one koje imaju hipertenziju i dijabetes, i da poredimo te grupe, da li je došlo do razlikovanja, odnosno da li bolest utiče na razlik u prodoru. Pored samog ranitidina ispitane su još tri supstance, odnosno tri leka koji se daju u okviru premedikacije za carski rez. Carski rez, da kažem, elektivni ili odnosno onaj koji se nalazi u redovnom programu, iz prostog razloga što je kontrolisano lekove i doze koje će se dati. Mogli smo da pratimo tačke kad je lek davan i da odredimo tačnije kako je to uticalo na prolazak kod deteta. Pa nagrada bi značila da taj istraživački rad, odnosno to čega sam ja usmerena kao istraživač, da je to nešto se može prepoznati kao istraživanje koje doprinosi kliničkim istraživanjima generalno. Mislim, čim rad vezan za to da je nagrađivan, znači da samo istraživanje ide, da kažem, u dobrom smeru.
The second finalist is Miss Iva Mucalo from Croatia.
By working at the Clinic for Internal Medicine of University Hospital Dubrava, colleague and me noticed a high proportion of irrational prescribing, especially to the elderly. So we wanted to carry out the research where we looked at the proportion of potentially inappropriate medications being prescribed to this especially vulnerable group of people, so to the elderly, and we wanted to see whether it has any influence on the negative clinical outcomes. And this is basically the broad picture of our work, and the first part of the results is published in an article which we sent to Medis. Our project is a result of a hard and dedicated work of a whole team of people, and today you have a chance to meet our youngest member, our youngest colleague, Ms. Andrea Brajković, who will be attending this fabulous event. Unfortunately, I won't be able to be with you, so since 5 months I have a new boss, a demanding one, not allowing me to travel much, so I think I'll stay here, and I wish all the contestants and finalists good luck and a pleasant evening to everyone.
And now, Miss Elina Marta Čmarković will be announced who is the winner.
And the winner is Mladena Lalić Popović.
Čestitamo. Unfortunately, Iva Mutsula is not here tonight, but she's replacing with Mrs. Andrea Brajković. She came on herself.
Jedna zajednička fotografija i sad mali govor. Mislim, može i malo veći. Izvolite.
Yeah, I didn't think really what to say. I didn't think I will get anything. So it's nice to get a reward, of course, but I don't think this is my reward, and only mine. It's the reward of people with whom I have worked. It's the reward of my mentor, Professor Miko, who teach me everything I know. And it is also a reward for my family, who was there for me and gave me all the strength I needed when I needed it. So thank you also, Medis Awards, for giving me, and the jury for giving me this. Thank you all.
Thank you, Madonna, once again, and congratulations. So we still have two more awards to be presented. The next one is in the field of pulmonology with allergology, and the finalists are Mr. Balázs Antus from Hungary.
We investigated exhaled carbon monoxide levels in healthy smokers and in water pipe users in different settings. And the result of the study was that exhaled carbon monoxide levels are much higher in water pipe users than in normal smokers. Well, if we win this award, we could go forward with our research activity here in our institute and investigate different pathways and pulmonary biomarkers in pulmonary patients, mainly in COPD patients.
Gospodin Antus, prvi finalista, and the second finalist is Miss Marina Labor from Croatia.
The aim of my study was to assess and develop a new, simple, non-invasive marker that will allow detection of chronic obstructive pulmonary disease in a preclinical stage, since symptoms, organ damage, and deprivation of quality of life often precede clinically relevant spirometric changes. We decided for exhaled breath temperature measurement to assess the susceptibility to a cigarette smoke in smokers at risk for COPD. Results after a 2-year follow-up have shown that the change of exhaled breath temperature after smoking cigarette at initial visit was significantly predictive for disease progression, either newly diagnosed COPD or stage progression. This is the first time ever that a single marker measured at single time point had the potential to predict future development of COPD.
And Miss Marta Čmarković will announce the winner.
And the winner is Marina Labor.
Congratulations, čestitamo!
Čestitamo još jednom.
Wow, this was a surprise for me. I'm very delighted and honored to be chosen for this award. I would like to thank to Medis Group and their scientific committee for recognizing my work. And I would like to thank to my collaborators for all the effort put in this work. Thank you very much.
Congratulations once more, čestitamo. And now, on to our last but not least, 2017 Medis Award in Rheumatology. The finalists are Mr. Jaka Ostrovšnik from Slovenia.
In addition to regular duties, we are also implemented a lot in vasculitis research. So receiving this award would be a great honor. You know, when you have a pleasure of working with such experts every day, you don't really get a feeling that your work makes any impact. this award would be a great confirmation that I'm on the right track.
The second finalist is Mr. Ivan Padjan from Croatia.
In this paper, we explored the association between serum hemoglobin levels and the vast array of parameters used in the assessment of patients with rheumatoid arthritis. In our analysis, we found out that serum hemoglobin levels are more strongly associated with parameters of disease activity than any other laboratory parameter. I'm honored to have been selected as a finalist of this year's MIRIS Awards in the field of rheumatology. This is a great encouragement both for myself and for my department to continue our research activities and our collaborations with our international partners.
And now, Ms. Marta Čmarković, open the envelope, and the winner is...
And the winner is... Ivan Padjan.
Mr. Ivan Padjan from Croatia.
I'm truly honored to have been selected as a winner of this MIRIS Awards for 2017 in the field of rheumatology, and I congratulate also MIRIS for this great initiative. I'm also grateful to my team from Zagreb for their support, and especially my mentor from Vienna, Dr. Daniel Artaha, for his guidance through this project. Also grateful to my family and my wife.
Congratulations, čestitam još jednom.
Before we wrap up the award-winning ceremonies, we will announce the MEDIS Award for the Best Multicentric Pan-European Research. This is a unique award for the Best Multicentric Pan-European Study, which has been published in a renewed journal with high IF among all the 166 received applications this year. And the winner is Jelena Vojnović from Serbia.
First of all, I would like to be recognized that this publication and multi-center international pan-European study is a result of the long-term research I have performed in the last 20 years. We have tested the possibility to use in everyday clinical practice a questionnaire that will test the level or necessity for the vitamin D or sufficiency of vitamin D in patients with rheumatoid arthritis without measuring of its level in the blood. As a result, we hope that this will be a new clinical tool for the patients with rheumatoid arthritis, but as well with many other diseases that can be used throughout the Europe. Multinational studies are very important, so this award means that these efforts and this kind of work should be recognized among young researchers to always try to make their work in collaboration with the colleagues from neighboring countries and all Europe.
Dame I gospodo, Jelena Vojnović, izvolite I čestitamo.
I'm really proud tonight because Serbia and Belgrade as a host city could be had an opportunity to be awarded with a special award. As I understood, this is the first time type of the award of a special recognition, and I found out that this is a recognition of the long-term efforts done in Serbian rheumatology and immunology. and especially a special approach, which is multidisciplinary, which is multinational, you could say international. Matija and Serbian Rheumatology Society are working together for a long time. So the most important message I would like to give to the all young investigators presented tonight is that it is possible, if you have a desire, have a good scientific idea, and you stand on it, you can involve a lot of international colleagues in the work. So you will be privileged, as I am at the moment, to live in Serbia and be an international expert. Thank you.
Congratulations, Ms. Jelena Vojinović. Čestitke još jednom. Ako nisam rekao, ponovit ću. Thank you, Mr. Strand and Ms. Marković Martać. Congratulations to all the winners and finalists. Let us enjoy the grand finale of the 2017 Medis Awards with Una Saga Serbica. I slušat ćemo i gledati Kalaj Kolo.
Svaka čast, evo, divna plesna numera za sam kraj, si mi tu, nemoj da mi pobegneš, dobro. In the end, we would like to present our artistic performance again. The dancers, Una Saga Serbica, please.
Give them one big applause. Applause only. Željko Joksimović and the group Čegi. Thank you for all entertainment.
Yes. So, be inspired, inspire others with your work and help to change the world for the better.
Hoćemo li da se slikamo još ili samo da se zahvalimo?
Ne znam, piti one koji su najviše trenirali večeras ovde.
Da li biste možda ponovo na scenu da napravimo zajedničku fotografiju sa svim pobednicima?
Hajde spontano da odlučimo sada, da li ste za?
Ajde, izvolite. Ajmo da ih pozovemo. Dakle, da još jednom pozdravimo. We kindly invite all award winners as well as Mr. Tone Srnad, Miss Martina Perharić, Miss Albina Pečarić, Miss Elina Marković Martać, Professor Dr. Matija Tomšić, winners to come on stage for a big photo, family photo. Please.
So, we also invite all guests to join us for a less formal reception on the first floor outside the hall. Yeah.
And there will be 2018 Medis Awards contest, the fifth contest. So see you next year in Sarajevo. So on behalf of Medis, I wish you a happy, healthy, and successful new year. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen, and enjoy.
Thank you and take care.